In this video I want to explain the Hashin damage criterion for fiber reinforced plastics. So you find it in the property module, then go to material manager, then create mechanical, and then here damage for fiber reinforced composites, Hashin damage. Okay, in the next part we will explain every single variable here. Okay, first off, what is a Hashin criterion? The Hashin criterion is a criterion to predict the failure of a composite material, and it is based here on this article. And here are the corresponding equations. And for those equations, you need strength parameters for tensile, compressive, and shear strengths, and they will be explained in the following. For example, we have here an unidirectional laminate and it is loaded by tension, and here we have a stress strain curve. And the maximum value in this stress strain curve is the longitudinal tension strength, and this is the first value in the Abaqos user interface here for Hashin damage. And for example, it is 1200 megapascals. Okay, and now I will show a short clip of a tensile test of a composite specimen. Okay, next we have longitudinal compression. And in this case, we have here again the stress strain diagram, and here in the negative direction, we have compression. And this is this value, and for example, it can be like 972 megapascals. And now I will also show a short clip of a composite specimen under compression. Okay, next we have transverse tensile strengths, as can be seen here. And in this case, it is much lower than the longitudinal tensile strengths in most cases. And for example, we have here 37 megapascals. Next we have transverse compressive strengths, as is shown here in this case. And here in this diagram. And for example, we can have like 147 megapascals. It is in general higher than the transverse tensile strengths. Okay, next we have shear, longitudinal shear strengths, as can be seen here. And in this example, we have like 72 megapascals. And then we have also transverse shear. And in this case, it is not that much lower than the longitudinal shear. It is about 50%, for example. Okay, and here you can see an example for transverse shear. Okay, and now let's take a look at the Abaqos result for an Hashin damage. Okay, here we have a composite tube. It is very thick. And it is loaded by axial compression. And here are the variables: Hashin fiber compression, Hashin fiber tension, Hashin matrix compression, and Hashin matrix tension. Okay, now let's take a closer look. Let's increase here the loading, and you see already that we have here in here the hole a change in color. And if the Hashin criterion exceeds 1, we have damage. So in this case, we have now here 1, here at this edge, and here at this edge. And this means that according to the Hashin criteria, we would have here some kind of damage. And as you can see, it can even exceed 1. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and until next time.